The next topic of discussion in continuation to the unit statistics. The first part what we dealt was curve fitting. Curve fitting involves fitting of a straight line curve, that is parabola, second degree parabola we call it as. And last part or last segment was fitting of exponential curves or power curve, or we call it as geometric curve, right? So these were all the curves which we dealt with, the three different types of. The next portion of discussion is correlation and regression. So correlation and regression are the terms which are going hand in hand, right? So in a particular example which will be provided, the data which will be provided to us, in that we will be asked to find out the correlation coefficient and also to obtain the equation of lines of regression. So in such cases, whenever we need to deal with the topic correlation and regression, we must first understand what actually they mean in statistics or in mathematics. So what is correlation? Correlation is a statistical tool which quantifies the intensity or degree of relationship between quantitative variables. Correlation is particularly a statistical tool which will give you, it is a particular numerical value which will give you the degree of relationship between the quantitative variables. Now, what do you understand or what do you mean by the quantitative variables? Quantitative variables means the data which will be provided in the question. The data to be provided in the question will again be values of x as well as y. In curve fitting also, for the given number of points or given set of observations, we used to try to obtain the best fit equation of the curve. Similarly, whatever information for x as well as y or the values will be provided to us, we will be trying to obtain the intensity or the degree of relationship which will be represented by a single numerical value. That numerical value can be positive, that numerical value can be negative. So in short, correlation is nothing but determining the nature or effect of variable, effect of one variable on the other. So if one variable value increases and other variable value also increases, there is a positive correlation. If one variable value decreases but other variable value increases, we say that there is negative correlation. So what does correlation? Correlation dictionary meaning is related to each other. So ultimately, I am interested in finding out a numerical value which will quantify the relationship between the variables, that means the values of x and y in the data which is provided. So it may be observed that in all ideal cases, there must be relationship between two quantities like income and expenditure. Income and expenditure are correlated with each other. Volume and pressure of a perfect gas. Similarly, two coins tossed simultaneously, the outcome is either head or a tail. So such clubbing of the quantities can be done so that we can easily try to find out the relationship between the two variables or the quantities. So definition, in short, it is said as, if the change in one variable affects the change in other variable, the variables are said to be correlated. That means ultimately I will be determining the value, or that value will be the representation determining the change. Whether changing in one variable has affected the other variable or not, that is ultimately what correlation is. Two variables x and y are said to be correlated if increase or decrease in one variable is accompanied by increase or decrease in the other variable. So two variables x and y are said to be correlated if increase or decrease in one variable is accompanied by increase or decrease in other variable. if x and y increased together, that means x also increases, correspondingly y also increases, or x and y decrease together, that means x decreases, y also decreases, the variables x and y are said to be positively correlated as shown in the figure. So x is also increasing, y is also simultaneously. See, x is representing these points, so they are in the increasing order. Y is also representing this, they are in the increasing order. So we say that they are positively correlated. If y decreases as x increases, x increases, y decreases, or x decreases, y increases, then they are said to be negatively correlated. That means it is a downward movement. So accordingly, x is increasing and y is decreasing. So in that sense, we say that it is negatively correlated. If in the scatter diagram, points do not lie about any curve, either may be linear or non-linear, the variables are said to be uncorrelated. So here if I draw the graph in the Cartesian coordinate system x versus y, the particular figure is neither linear nor non-linear, we say that the variables are uncorrelated. So scatter diagram, points do not lie about any curve, no pattern is being observed. So in that case, the conclusion will be, or the inference will be, the variables are said to be uncorrelated. The correlation between the two variables is said to be simple correlation. Whenever we are talking about only two variables, the correlation is said to be simple correlation. The correlation between more than two variables is called as, or is known as, multiple correlation. The correlation between more than two variables, then it will be called as multiple correlation. So this is the rough background or the theory, introductory part for the correlation. Now I will be asked to find out coefficient of correlation, which is called as Karl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. In our problems, we will be required to find out Karl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Why Karl Pearson's? Because it was invented by British biometrician Karl Pearson. Therefore, the process is named after him. And our ultimate goal will be to determine the coefficient of correlation. Coefficient of correlation or Karl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, it is one and the same thing. So as a measure of intensity or a degree of linear relationship between two variables x and y, Karl Pearson, a British biometrician, developed the formula called correlation coefficient. Coefficient of correlation, Karl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, or correlation coefficient, it is one and the same thing. Now how it is denoted by and how it is calculated? So correlation coefficient between two variables x and y is usually denoted by r of xy, which can also be written as r suffix xy, or it is simply r, which is a numerical measure of linear relationship between x and y. So coefficient of correlation is denoted by simply r, or r suffix xy, or r of xy, which is a numerical relationship or numerical measure of linear relationship between the variables x and y. But what is the definition of it? The definition of r is, the notation used is small r, but how to calculate, what is the formula for correlation coefficient or coefficient of correlation? It is r is equal to summation xy, summation capital xy upon under root of, summation capital xy upon under root of summation x square into summation y square. Don't take it as x square y square. x square y square is a different quantity. Summation x square y square is never same as summation x square into summation y square, because capital X square will be a separate column, capital Y square will be a separate column, and their individual summations will be taken. So what is the formula for r? Formula for small r is summation capital X into Y, this is combined X Y, upon under root of summation X square into summation Y square. But what is capital X? Capital X is X minus X bar. What is capital Y? Y minus Y bar. So capital X is X minus X bar, capital Y is Y minus Y bar. But what are these called as? These are called as deviations of the variables X and Y from their respective mean. X bar yane kya hota hai? Mean. Y bar means what? Mean. So capital X is nothing but deviation of variable X from its mean. What is capital Y? Deviation of Y from its mean Y bar. Now tell me how to calculate mean. Mean X bar is summation X upon N, sum of all observations upon total number of observations. What is Y bar? Y bar is summation Y upon N. What is summation Y upon N? Sum of all observations of Y upon N. What is N? N is number of pairs of observation. So X bar and Y bar are nothing but mean, which is summation X upon N and summation Y upon N. Calculate the capital X and capital Y, which will be the deviation or difference of random variable with its corresponding mean. Draw the table, calculate the requisite values, then coefficient of correlation R will be summation capital XY upon under root of summation X square into under root of summation Y square. So apart from the column of X and Y, I will be generating column for capital X, I will be generating column for capital Y, I will be generating column for XY, X square and Y square. This is what the requirement is. How to calculate capital X and capital Y? X minus X bar, Y minus Y bar. X bar and Y bar are respectively mean, which will be a fixed quantity, unique quantity. Every observation has to be subtracted from the mean, will be subtracted from every observation. This particular Y में से सब्ट्रैक्ट करना है मीन वाई बार, एंड दैट विल बी गिविंग यू द वैल्यूज ऑफ कैपिटल एक्स एंड कैपिटल वाई. सो व्हाट इज एन? एन इज द नंबर ऑफ पेयर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन. सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला विच इज कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट और कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन डिनोटेड बाय आर, ऑल्सो नोन एज कार्ल पियर्सन कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट या कार्ल पियर्सन कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन. So there are certain various properties related to R. What are they? The correlation coefficient cannot exceed unity numerically. Means the value of correlation coefficient cannot exceed 1 as well as minus 1. Numerically ka matlab hota hai modulus. Modulus of any quantity ka matlab hai any value can be negative whose modulus is plus. Any positive value whose modulus is plus. So coefficient correlation ya correlation coefficient cannot exceed unity numerically, means it always lies between minus 1 and 1. So magnitude of R determines the degree of correlation. So your values will always lie between minus 1 and 1. So variable having the values or related with the related with each other giving you the value in the positive sense, I say that it is a positive correlation, right? Rather if it is plus 1, so I will say that there is perfect positive correlation. If R is equal to minus 1, it indicates that there is perfect negative correlation. But if it is not exactly 1, suppose R is equal to minus 0.5, so it will determine that the correlation is a negative correlation. Suppose R is equal to coming up as positive 6, 0.6238, surely that value should be less than 1. So if it is coming out as R is equal to positive 0.6238, we say that it is a positive correlation. When it is exactly plus 1, it is perfect positive correlation. When it is exactly minus 1, it is perfect negative correlation. What about if it is equal to 0? If it is equal to 0, the variables x and y are uncorrelated. There does not exist any correlation or relationship between x and y. 0 lies between minus 1 and 1. So, if it is equal to 0, we say that the variables are uncorrelated. So, what are the properties of correlation coefficient? The properties of correlation coefficient are the values of R lies between minus 1 and 1. This we have seen. Correlation coefficient is independent of change of origin and scale. This will not depend on origin, neither it will depend on scale. It is completely independent quantity or a numerical measure. X and Y are independent, means they are not dependent on each other, means they are uncorrelated. That means the value of R comes out to be 0. They are not related to each other. They are not dependent on each other, means they are independent. They are independent means they are uncorrelated. There does not exist any correlation between the two values of variables, between the two variables x and y, that means the value of R, which signifies the measure or degree of relationship between the two variables x as well as y. So this is what we talk about, the rough background of the correlation coefficient.